My FFA evolution began whenever I first memorized the FFA Creed. When I first looked at those five paragraphs, I thought there was no way in the world I was going to memorize that many words. But I persisted and eventually got it down. And that accomplishment, although small, led me to participating in my first public speaking contest, and from that moment on, I was hooked. I began to want to take advantage of every opportunity that came my way within the blue and gold. So, I began competing in CDEs, participating in livestock showing, and even started my own landscape company through my supervised agriculture experience. Through these involvements, FFA has shown me that everybody has a light inside of them, but it's up to them to let it shine. The first two words of that creed I memorized are "I believe." FFA provides the perfect environment for students to learn and grow, but most of all, believe in themselves to let their light shine.
When I first stepped into the ag building, I had no idea what to expect. I didn't show livestock, I didn't live on a farm, and I didn't know how I'd fit into the FFA program. It didn't take long before that quickly changed, largely in part due to a junior named Caleb Horn. I remember after my first ever Cree competition, Caleb handed me a folder. In this folder was everything that he had used to prepare himself for his national Cree competition when he was a freshman. I can still remember the sense of gratitude I felt when an upperclassman that I hardly knew entrusted me with his folder. A folder that represented all of the time and effort that Caleb put into being the best at everything that he did. Caleb has this unique ability to make everyone feel deserving, important, and special. He sees the best in people, and he's always had an infectious smile. Caleb has this unique ability to make everyone he comes in contact with feel deserving, important, and special. He sees the best in people and is always there with an upbeat attitude, an infectious smile, and a natural ability to make everybody feel like they belong.
You may know him as your state president, but he's my fishing buddy. There is one thing that you should know about Caleb: that man loves to do some fishing. Personally, I was never the big fishing type until the summer before my senior year when Caleb offered to take me on my birthday. On our first fishing expedition, instead of catching fish myself, most of my time was consumed by watching Caleb catch fish. Despite struggling to get a bite at first, I kept on fishing, and a few moments later, I finally felt a tug on my line. I set the hook and reeled and reeled, and after a few moments, I had finally caught a fish. After I got the fish off the hook, Caleb ran over from his fishing spot, took my picture, and jokingly said, "Happy birthday, bud," and gave me a pat on the back. Then I pointed out to him that in the time it took Caleb to catch 20 or so fish, I'd only caught one. But Caleb looked back at the fish, looked at me, and told me that when I caught that one single fish, I had accomplished something that he had never done before: catch a fish on his birthday. That's the type of person that Caleb is. No matter what he accomplishes or does, he is always the one to stay humble and finds ways to encourage those around him. FFA members and guests, it's my honor to introduce to you my friend,
my mentor,
and your state president, Caleb Horn. I'm gonna miss her when I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore and I'm sitting in the sun.
Well, she ain't much, but she'll do. Meet the SS Silly Goose, my personal swamp puppy catching machine. When I first got her, she hadn't been used in years. She didn't have a deck or a motor. She had some drainage issues and lots of spiders. But after a couple days of hard work, determination, blood, sweat, tears, and elbow grease, she was ready to get out on the water. There's nothing I love more than waking up early on a warm summer morning and heading out to the lake to chase after those big old bass just hiding in the water. Truth be told, oftentimes when I tell my family that I'll be gone for most of the day fishing, they can be reminded of those lyrics we heard by Brad Paisley just a second ago. Well, I love them, but I love to fish. Fellas, am I right? Yeah, I am. All jokes aside, I genuinely love fishing. It's my happy place. Somewhere where I can go, that's not good. Somewhere where I can go to get away from all the worries of the world and just think. We all have those places, don't we? Maybe for you it's not on a John boat in the middle of a lake. Maybe it's on the front porch, having a cup of coffee with your grandpa. Maybe it's in the speech room, maybe it's in the ag barn, maybe it's on the baseball field. Regardless of where it is, we all have somewhere where we can go to just think and ponder and process all of the mysterious questions that life throws our way. Like, oh boy, I really like this girl. Should I make a move right now or wait? Fellas, let me tell you, always make the first move. Ladies, am I right? or another common one, is water wet? Why do ships carry cargo and cars carry shipments? It doesn't make any sense. Or maybe for you, it's a little bit more of a serious question. What do I want to do with the rest of my life? There's so many different jobs and careers and opportunities out there. How am I ever going to just pick one? Will I ever accomplish this? Will I ever have a family of my own? What's my purpose? Where did we come from? And how can I find fulfillment in a world that's full of hate and chaos and bitter people? Well, I don't have all the answers. But today, I want to talk about what I've learned and the wisdom that I've earned. And last but not least, I want to say goodbye. FFA members, purpose, passion, and action. Those are the three words that I want to talk about today. Can we say those together? Purpose, passion, and action. What's your purpose? What were you put in this world to do? What are some of the things that you're passionate about in life, and how can you put those two together to live your life to the fullest? Let's jump back over here to the SS Silly Goose. Now, there's always a few things that I keep on me when I'm fishing. You gotta have a rod and reel, of course, and you gotta have some snacks and a life jacket for safety, of course. Sorry, Mom, I may not wear my life jacket all the time. But the most important thing I keep on me when I'm fishing is this: my handy dandy tackle box, equipped with everything that I can need for any situation that Mother Nature would throw my way. In this tackle box, I've got green pumpkin spintail worms, perfect for Texas rigging and bouncing along weed lines, jigs for when weather conditions might be just a little bit rough, and my personal favorite, topwater frogs, perfect for when the sun is first coming up or sinking low, the water is completely still, and the fish are hungry. In that orange tackle box, I've got anything for any situation that I could pull up to the water to. But when I think of a tackle box, there's another box that comes to mind. Has anyone in here ever heard of a tack box? Do we have any livestock showmen in the house tonight? Yeah. Well, back in my glory days, I showed pigs, specifically Burke Barrows and Crossgilts for all of my hog showmen out there. And when I first started showing, my ag teacher at the time, Mr. Thompson, was kind enough to lend me his tack box from when he was in high school. And I'm sorry, Mr. Thompson, but similar to the SS Silly Goose, it wasn't in great shape at all. It needed a lot of tender love and care before I began to fill it with everything Mr. Thompson said that I would need to succeed in the show ring. And throughout my time showing, what I had in my tack box didn't really change that much. I added a few things here and there, but nothing crazy. Until one night. It was just after a CDE practice, and my buddy Ty and I were headed down to the yak barn to feed our pigs. It was night out, so it was hard to see. We were tripping a lot. I had two pigs at the time. Their names were Forrest and Jenny, like off of one of my favorite movies, Forrest Gump. Jenny was a cross gilt, and she didn't have much personality to her at all. But Forrest, on the other hand, he was a Burke Barrow. And if you know anything about Burke Barrows, you know that there are always two things. My boy Forrest was always hungry, and he was full of energy. But ironically, Forrest was a third thing. The pig named Forrest somehow loved to run. It's funny how we truly live up to our names, isn't it? But he was constantly known for breaking out of his pen and running around the barn, leaving me to try and chase him down, which isn't always the easiest thing to do. But that night, as I was scooping feed out into the feeder, I heard a loud ping, heard Forrest burst out of his pen, out of the barn, and into the nighttime. My pig was on the loose in the dark, and it was up to Ty and I to try to catch him back. So we burst out of the barn doors and into the night like Batman and Robin searching for the city's supervillain. My pig was on the loose, and it was up to us to try to catch him. It was night out, so it was hard to see. But we looked around front where we kept the ag trailers, and he wasn't anywhere to be seen. So we turned around to the other side of the building where we kept the old pens, and he wasn't there either. Then we looked in the back where we kept the wood chips, and he wasn't there either. And we looked around by the sheep, and he wasn't there either. My pig was lost in the dark. And I was getting a little bit worried that my dad was about to be really mad at me for losing my show pig. But don't worry, because when all hope was just about lost, not being able to see anything in the dark, Ty and I ventured back inside, a little worried. And Forrest had somehow made his way back into the wash bin, which was weird because he hated baths. But long story short, we found him. That was one of my most humiliating moments in FFA. My pig outsmarted me. Imagine getting outsmarted by a pig. It's not that fun. But FFA members, I added something new to my tack box that night. A flashlight, not ice cream. And let me tell you, it came in handy several times because Forrest was an escape artist. But FFA members and guests, let's take a step back for a second. Let's think about the analogy that we've just created using a pig, a flashlight, and the nighttime. What's your purpose? What were you put in this world to do? Let me be very, very honest with you here for just a moment, FFA members. Let's level. We live in a dark world. There are people in this world who don't wish for you to succeed. There are people who will turn their back on you in a heartbeat. Natural disasters, sickness, pain, cancer, mental health, suicide, that's real stuff that people face every single day. The question of life isn't whether you will face challenges or not, it's how you'll step up and combat them. We live in a dark world. So FFA members, what's your purpose? It's to be a light. You were called to be a flashlight in the nighttime. God says that he made you as the light of the world, a city set on a hill. You were made to do good works with the things that you've been given. The only way to beat the darkness is to rise above it, FFA members, and outshine it. So shine as bright as you can. That's your purpose. That's what you were called to do. That's the reason why we're here. We are called to be a flashlight in the nighttime. But now that we've established our purpose, what's next? You guys remember those three words? Purpose, passion, action. Let's say them together. Purpose, passion, and action. Passion, the next step in our three-part equation to fulfillment. Think for a second. What are you good at? What do you love to do? What are some things that you are naturally talented and able to do that maybe others aren't so much? Those, my friends, are your passions. Watch this clip from one of my favorite movies, Secretariat.
The field is at the post. Chick Anderson with the call. Horses now loaded in. They're off. Secretariat surging from the gate. Secretariat away very well. Has good position on the rail. Secretariat driving immediately into the lead. Secretariat and Jam off to a surprisingly rapid pace.
He's going out too fast.
Secretariat, Jam on the outside is also moving along strongly. And now it's Jam. Jam and Secretariat are right together in the first turn. By Gallant has third behind them. Then it's Twice a Prince and the trailer is private
smiles. Why is he going to
lead? They go by the
turn. I don't know.
Jam pushing Secretariat into an even faster pace as they round the first turn. Jam pressing Secretariat even faster. Secretariat refusing to yield, driving forward.
This is unbelievable. No horse can take this pace.
Jam pushes forward to challenge for the rail.
Come on, man. Come on.
Three quarters of blistering 109 and 4. 109 and 4. Secretariat and Jam locked in a deadly duel. Secretariat and Cham.
Oh, man, this is a catastrophe.
No, it's too fast.
Third and Secretariat.
Let it run, Ronnie. Let it run.
Cham and Secretariat pulling away at blazing speed. With a half mile still to run, Secretariat's sprinting away. Entering the final turn, Secretariat is moving like a tremendous machine.
That's impossible.
He laughs at fear, afraid of nothing. He does not shy away from the sword. He cannot stand still when the trumpet sounds.
Thank you.
Man, can we give it up for Secretariat? Come on. Wow. Man, doesn't that just make your blood tingle? Makes me want to run through a wall or something whenever I see Secretariat go, wow, he's fast. For those of you wondering, on this day in 1973, Secretariat became the first horse in over 25 years and the last horse to ever do it to win the Triple Crown, setting records for all three races in the process. Well, you guys may have heard or at least seen Secretariat now, or maybe own a pair of Ariat jeans, the brand which he inspired, by the way. The story you may not know is the one about Secretariat's owner. Penny Chinnery was a housewife and mother of five who unexpectedly found herself thrust into the world of thoroughbred horse racing. When Penny's mother died, she inherited the family farm. And despite not knowing much about the horse racing industry and it being a male-dominated industry, she was determined to make a success out of what she'd been given. See, FFA member, she was passionate. She was determined to be successful. Things weren't looking too great for the farm, but she believed in the potential of a foal that was born out of mare something royal sired by a bold ruler. That foal showed signs of promise from an early age. And under Penny's management, Secretariat went on to achieve remarkable things, setting records for the Belmont, the Preakness, and the Kentucky Derby in 1973, winning the Triple Crown. However, Secretariat probably wouldn't have accomplished this if he hadn't had Penny's support behind him. You see, she had a knack for horses, and she knew it. And she was determined to use that, her passions, to do something good. And her life was better because of it. FFA members, ag teachers, businesses, sponsors, anyone here tonight, parents, I've got news for you. If you didn't know it, this organization is one of a kind. We have a certain knack for instilling passion within our students. Here at Oklahoma FFA, we breed hard workers. And I'm determined, and I know that if you are looking for a place where you can come to learn, grow, find success, and find your passions, this is the place for you. And we've got a place for you. I'm not all bark, no bite, though. I've personally been affected throughout my time in this organization. Let's real quick take a flashback to eighth grade Caleb. I'm not going to show you a picture or anything because I just do myself dirty there. But in FFA, or in eighth grade, I didn't really do much in FFA. You see, I wasn't bought in yet. It actually wasn't until my freshman year, when I got hurt playing baseball, that my ag teacher encouraged me to become more involved in FFA. And I did. I found my passions. And I began to live life to the fullest. You see, I memorized the creed. And then I went to a contest. And then I wanted to go to more contests. So I started traveling the state and meeting all of these amazing people and getting all of these amazing experiences and friends. And as I was traveling the state, beginning to compete in CDs, LDs, starting my own supervised agriculture experience, going to national convention, state convention, and alumni camp, I realized that FFA and life, more than those achievements and those backdrops and those buckles and those banners and awards, FFA in life, it's about discovering your passions, discovering what you were meant to do. FFA members, I want you to know something. I believe that God was at work that spring whenever I got hurt. And I want you all to know that I believe in a God above that created the heavens and the earth and loves you so much that he sent his son to die so that you could be with him again one day. And I believe that that exact same God has given each and every one of you talents and abilities that you can use to make a positive difference in this world. And I believe that that same God has a plan for you. FFA members, that's my purpose. And that's my passion. It's to love God, love people, and make his goodness known. I'm so thankful that FFA has given me an opportunity to do that. What's your purpose? What's your passion? How will you serve God with your life? And who will you inspire to do the same? You know, there's been several people in my life who've had a pretty big impact on it. After all, you know, speech shows and stock shows, they don't run themselves. And I definitely didn't do my laundry every time I came home late from a speech contest or baseball game. So now, I think it's time that I hand out a pretty few special thank yous. Ms. McQuiston, I've got something for you. Please take these tissues in case you cry. Guys, I'm so thankful for each and every one of you talking to the ag teachers right now. You know, it's funny when I have a conversation with someone and they ask, who is your ag teacher? I always have to go, well, which one? Because I had seven. But despite there being so many of you, your impact on me remains the same. I'm so thankful for all the time that we've got to spend together, the early mornings, the late nights, the shows, the speech contests, the Wendy's runs, the gallon of water I bought you at that gas station one time when you just wanted a little bit, and Mr. Thompson, all the memories that we have together. I'm so thankful for each and every one of you. And I know that I miss being in the ag building joking around with you guys, but you prepared me for a life beyond high school. Thanks for investing in me and giving me an opportunity to succeed in the FFA. Love you guys. Now to the fam. Deidre, man, I couldn't think of a more dynamic duo than we're like the peanut butter and jelly of brothers and sisters, aren't we? Especially when it comes to pranking mom and dad and making forts. You know, from the time you're little, you've always been super smart and determined. I've always been a little bit jealous of you because you've been a little bit better at me than everything. But I know you're going to go on to accomplish great things. And you refuse to call me it now because you're too old and cool, but your Bubba will always be here for you. And I love you so much. Mom, don't worry. I also brought tissues for you. Mom, you truly epitomize the phrase, let your light shine. And throughout my time at home and even in college, you've always made sure that I try to do that exact same thing, just like you've shown me how to do. I'm so thankful that you were there for me on those late nights and early mornings with a hug, a word of encouragement, telling me to drink my water and be safe, and to make me a snack when I was hungry, and all the time that we've got to spend together. I'm so glad that you're my mom. I love you. Dad, man, from the time I was little, you've always taught me to never settle for less. Whether that was in FFA or baseball or sports or anything that I put my mind to, even Mario Kart on the Wii, you made sure that I accomplished my goals. It still seems like yesterday that we were getting done with pool play, baseball games, and going back home and mowing lawns, and I was on the push mower and picking up sticks, and you were on the rider so that we could get done as fast as we could so that we could get back home, play some Mario Kart, and Mom wouldn't be mad at us before supper. Truly are a man of God. I hope that one day I'm going to be able to invest in my family just like you've invested in ours. I love you so much. Guys, although I've moved off to college now and I don't get to see you as much, I still love you just the same. And I hope that, you know, I look forward to coming home every chance I get. And I'm always going to be there for you to support you the way that you guys have been there for me. I love you so much. Now, last year's team. You know, I could talk about out-of-pocket comments, but I will choose not to. Guys, it's crazy it's already been a year, isn't it? Although we're at college now and have gone our separate ways, I'll never forget doing the last ever alumni camp at Tulakoi together, going skiing, falling a bunch of times, and letting Emily and Braden help me up, even though I kept falling several times. Georgia falling off that bench and becoming our lock screen. And guys, our year of service together was amazing. And although we've kind of gone our separate ways now in college, and we don't get to see each other a lot anymore, I love you guys. And I know that the friendship that we have is going to last us a lifetime. Now to this year's team, you guys don't matter. Nah, I'm just kidding. Guys, I've absolutely loved getting to serve this year with you. You know, from the beginning, I didn't know that we were going to catch a mouse in a hotel room, or that Garrett was going to get run over by Kayla driving a gator, or that we'd have to deal with Trey's indecisiveness, Pedro's peacemaking abilities, Alex's deep conversations, Claire and Kylie's pranks. It's crazy. This year has been an absolute roller coaster of a ride. Whether we like it or not, tomorrow, most of us are done. And we get to start moving on to a new chapter outside of the FFA organization. But I know that the memories we've made together, the experiences we have, and the friendships that we've gained are going to last us a lifetime. I love you all so much. And I hope that you guys have gotten just as much out of this year as I have. FFA members and guests, each and every one of these people behind me have made a profound impact on my life. If it weren't for them, I wouldn't have had several of the opportunities that I've been fortunate enough to have today. Do you know why they've been able to make such a big impact on me, though? Do you know the core principle of success that has driven each and every one of them to go out and do something with their lives? They found their purpose. They know what they were put in this world to do. They found their passions. They know the things they're good at that they can use to make a positive change on this world. And last but not least, they put those things into action. Action. The last part of our three-part equation to fulfillment. What were those words again? Let's say them together. Purpose, passion, and action. Action is such a simple word, but oftentimes the most difficult part to execute. Let me give you this analogy. Let's jump back over to the SS Silly Goose one more time. Now, I'm no pro, but I do love fishing, and I can catch a couple if you get me out on this old John boat. So today, I want to leave you with a few things that I've learned from my fishing expeditions that I like to call Caleb's totally accurate and real, laws of fishing. Caleb's law of fishing, number one. Stories make fish bigger. It's true. Isn't all my fellow fishermen out there know that that one is true? Every time you catch a fish and tell a story about it, it automatically just gets a little bit bigger. Don't ask me how it happens. I don't make the rules. It just happens. Papa, Grandpa, I love you guys, but the stories that you tell me of the fish you catch when you were little, they definitely were not that big. They definitely were not. There's no way. There's no way. I love you guys, though, and it's okay because we don't track that. We just keep count. Caleb's law of fishing number two. No flick, no fish. There's only one way to prove that you caught a fish, and that, my friends, is if you have a picture of it. Now, this one goes hand in hand with the first because we all know that if it was really that big, you would have taken a picture with it anyways, right? Yeah. And Caleb's law of fishing number three. Now, here's where we get serious, FFA members. This one is called Get on the Water. You can have the best boat in the world with the most updated technology and fish finders that money can buy. An unlimited supply of bait, the best rods and reels, be on the number one lake in the nation with the number one fishing guide in your passenger seat. But if you don't drive to the lake and you don't put your boat in the water and you don't cast a line, you're never going to catch a fish. You have to take what you've been given and put it into action. Even the old SS Silly Goose can catch a couple fish if you get her out in the water. But FFA members, the same principle applies to you. You live in the number one nation in the history of the world with the most advancements in technology that humankind has ever seen. Each and every one of you are surrounded by people who love and care and want the best for you. And you get the chance to be a part of an amazing organization in the Oklahoma FFA Association. And you, above all, have God-given talents and abilities that you can use to make a positive difference in this world. So what are you going to do with it? How are you going to strive to get up and be 1% better than you were the day before? God didn't give you a spirit of fear or timidity, but of power and of love. You were created to put those things into action and do good works with the things that you've been given. So will you let it go to waste? Or will you continually strive for betterment, success, and action? Will you choose to live your life to the fullest? Purpose, passion, action. It's that simple. All you've got to do is let it shine. Now, as my time is coming to a close today, there's one more thing I'd like to do. Could everybody please take out their phones for me? Act teachers, if you've got them, pass them back out. It's okay. Trust me. You're welcome, FFA members. But I spoke earlier on how we all have a light inside of us, an ability to let our lights shine. But I want to expand on that just a little bit. Because while one light is really good, sometimes it takes multiple lights in order to light up a room. So I'd like you all to join me in a little representation right now. Hang on, guys, don't turn those flashlights on just yet. If you are a freshman or below in the room, will you turn your light on for me and hold it up in the air? Right now, you guys are probably just getting into FFA, or maybe like my little sister, you have an older FFA member. Now that's your brother or sister, and you got drug here. Guys, I want you to know something, FFA members, that anyone who is older than you in this room would change places in a heartbeat to be where you are today. You all have so many opportunities and experiences left within your lifetime, and I hope you'll take advantage of those. But most of all, I hope that you'll keep shining your light. Keep those lights on for me, guys. Sophomores and juniors, where are we at? Can you guys put up those lights for me? Let's go. Sophomores and juniors, you guys are getting into what I like to call the thick of it. You guys are getting into a lot of classes, and you're getting involved in extracurricular activities and an FFA, and life is probably just a little bit stressful, isn't it? Well, keep saying yes to the things that you love. And don't be afraid to say no to the things that you aren't so sure about. But as you go on throughout life, remember, keep shining that light. Seniors, where are we at? There we go. Guys, you are almost there. Tomorrow night, just like me, you're gonna zip up that FFA jacket for quite possibly one of the very last times. It's kind of sad. Moving off to college, entering the workforce, leaving home, that's scary stuff. It's okay to be scared, but it's your turn now to set an example for everyone else who will come behind you. As you move on in life, it's okay to be scared, but don't forget to call home every once in a while. Give your mom a hug. Cling to what's good, and most of all, keep on shining that light. Now, if you are a parent or grandparent or even great-grandparent in the room, will you turn your lights on for me? Guys, allow me to just say thank you. Thank you for all the time that you've poured into us. I think it's safe to say that none of these FFA members in here would be in the place they are today if it hadn't been for you guys. Thank you. Keep on shining that light and never let it grow dim. Anyone else in the room that hasn't turned their light on yet, will you hold that phone flashlight up for me? Now, regardless of whether you are an ag teacher, a college student, a sponsor, whoever you are, I want you all to know that you have an opportunity to let your light shine too. Because God made you as the light of the world. And I don't know what you're facing, but each and every one of us has a unique story. And just by being here right now, we're making an impact on those around us. Don't forget the ability that you have to let your light shine. FFA members, look around. Isn't that cool? You are just one light. And I am just one light. But together, we can make the whole arena glow. Each and every one of you right now is making an impact on those around you and setting an example for those who come behind you just by shining your light. Oklahoma FFA, I'm so thankful for the time that I've got to spend helping you lead this organization. Keep shining your lights. Find your purpose. Find your passions. Put it into action. And live your lives to the fullest. Thank you.
Said someday I hope you get the chance to live life.
Well, before we close, I'm excited.